Let's talk about Monday, the 5th of September, 2022. My name is Collins, and I'm coming to bother you again. This time I was going to tell you about my new book, which is called Matilda's Man. And it's actually, I think, the longest writing project that I've done before. Let's say the premise is that when people get together, like two people get together as a couple, they're going to influence each other's choices and philosophies and the actions that they take. And that, I guess that's kind of trite. That stands to reason. But I took a real-life example of what could happen differently if Abraham Lincoln, instead of marrying Mary Todd in the 1840s, had instead married Matilda Edwards. Now, when I started working on this story, I found out that some people didn't know there was such a thing as Matilda Edwards, which is reasonable because very little is known about her, but she was a real person. In late 1840, there's a lawyer in Springfield, working in Springfield, Illinois, whose name is Abraham Lincoln, and at the time, he is presumed engaged to marry Mary Todd. Mary Todd is a sort of member of the aristocracy in that place, and she's lodging with Ninian Edwards at his nice house. At the same time, there's this young woman named Matilda Edwards who comes up from Alton, Illinois, and she's the daughter of Cyrus Edwards, who's a pretty big politician in that state. So she's staying at her cousin's house. Her cousin is Ninian Edwards, and basically staying in the same house as Mary Todd. Now, what is this? So far, we're real life, okay? I haven't changed anything. It is known that Abraham Lincoln, in socializing at that house, fell head over heels in love with Matilda. And around the 1st of 1841... his engagement with Mary Todd broke off, and there's different theories about why that happened. Some people think that it was because he was in love with Matilda that he broke off his engagement with Mary, but there's no conclusive evidence about that. Matilda Edwards herself, later on, when she found out that Abraham had affections for her, said that she never knew. She had no idea that he even cared about her at all, which is probably understandable because he was probably too shy to say anything about it. In real life, a little over a year later, Abraham Lincoln came crawling back to Mary Todd and asked her to marry him. And they got married very hastily. And then they stayed married for a long time. And American history ended up as it did, with Abraham Lincoln ending up president of the United States. Nota bene, Mary Todd had promised herself since childhood that she would one day be the wife of a president. Now, what happens differently in my story is that that these two people, Lincoln and Matilda, find out that they're in love with each other. And when they find that out, they automatically kind of come together and they get married. Instead of Lincoln marrying Mary Todd, he marries Matilda Edwards. They end up living in a house about 3 miles outside of Springfield in an area called Sugar Creek. Up until this time now, Lincoln was a member of the Illinois legislature, so he was, because the new state house was at Springfield, and he was there, and he was also a practicing lawyer at the time. The thing is about it, though, is that in my story, Matilda turns out to be a person who doesn't want to marry a politician. She finds the politics business is just ugly and terrible and dirty and yucky. So what ends up happening is that Lincoln, decides to leave politics altogether so that he can be with the one he loves. And if you can believe that, then you might be able to believe the rest of the story, which I suppose I shouldn't tell you the whole thing. because so little is known about Matilda, I felt free to take some liberties with her personality, and I could develop her to be my own fictional version of whoever she really was. In almost every other respect, though, I was trying really hard to make it historically accurate, if you will, that if they read something in the newspaper, that newspaper really was being published at that time, and the people had the right ages and everything. So I tried to, one of the most time-consuming things about it was to try to find out as much as possible to make it so that this really could have happened. And what I'm hoping is that readers will find that it's not implausible, or the story is something they could believe happened. Because of the choices that people make being together and influencing each other, the things in the world will turn out a bit differently. And that's where it kind of gets interesting for me. And so that's what I was working on since sometime in April. Now I'm in the position where, okay, I'm done with that big project, and now what am I going to do with myself? And I'm thinking about what story I'm going to write next, because I have to be working on something all the time. That's about all I had to say about that. If you have anything to say about that, you can always put it there. I'm hoping that I'll still be here next week to bother you some more. But in the meantime, I hope that you and all your little life choices will have a feine Abend fare.